Bill, almost out of time, so what I would like to do now is the last song we'd like to do tonight is the first song that I wrote for Animaniacs. And this is the song with all the countries of the world. And Rob sings it.
Thank you. That's very kind of you. That's kind of our stairway to heaven, so thank you. But this really, in all seriousness, especially for those of you who are composers or in the show business type of thing, and I think one of the smartest things I did when I moved to Hollywood was to surround myself with people who are far more talented than I, present company included. And I did that because I know that as badass as I think I was, way not even close to the real deal. Case in point, Randy Rogel, firstly and foremostly, is a graduate of West Point. Okay, so right there, you're ahead of the game. Then he serves the country, says, I need another degree. So he goes to Boston University, way out of my league. Then he decides it's time to make a little money, so he gets a corporate gig in Seattle, doing really well. But his background is music. You grew up here in San Diego, right? And you worked
on... I grew up in San Diego.
Yeah?
And Rob really is my agent. He gets a lot of press too.
I'm his real estate agent. So Randy, his background is music, it's dance, it's singing, it's writing, it's all this stuff. So he says, you know what? If I never try, I'll never know. A lot of us have had that. Drops the gig, drives down to Pacific Coast Highway to LA, starts banging on doors, sleeps on couches, just like...
Slept on a friend's couch.
Eating ramen, bangs on the doors, finally gets a job at Warner Brothers Animation writing drama. He's writing on Batman, the animated series. Great show.
Batman was a good show, right?
For which... Right out of the chute, he wins an Emmy. So he's clearly made the right choice. Then he hears about the same folks who made Tiny Toon Adventures are doing a new show across the hall with Mr. Spielberg, and it's going to be a brand new show, clean sheet of paper, lots of music, comedy. So Randy says, I know, I can do that. Boom, boom, boom. Finally, after asking them over and over and over, Tom Ruger, the producer, I'll tell you what, Rodney, Randy, yeah, whatever. You go home and you write a song and bring it back in the context of Animaniacs, and if we like it, we'll see what happens. Ladies and gentlemen, this was his audition piece.
Remember that. Ladies and gentlemen, when they went into production, I was out of town, and so the director sent me, he FedExed me a cassette tape, and because I hadn't even met Rob yet, and I listened to it, so I called him, I said, hey, Rusty, who is this guy? He's really good. And Rusty said, Randy, he did it in one take. And I've always wondered if that's true. So tonight, we're going to see if Rob really can do it in one take.
Challenge accepted, but I'll tell you what, I'm as serious as a pimple on prom night, you guys. You are absolutely lovely to spend your evening with us.
And for us to do our final show of the season.
Yeah, this is really great. All of us are profoundly grateful because we know how fortunate we are to be in the happy business. And you can see tonight there are a lot of folks. It's not about a bunch of 10-year-olds. It's about the 10-year-old and a bunch of folks. And so thank you very much for sharing your lives with us. It's a pretty remarkable thing. So I think let's raise the ante a little bit. Why don't we just say that I'll do this? Yeah, because we're, but let's do it to picture. So I'll lip
sync. Oh, you're going to sing it to picture?
Yeah.
All right, but if he screws up, the picture keeps going. All right, Rob Paulsen's going to do Yakko's World without a net.
Yeah, that's right. All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, this song is entitled Yakko's World. And now, the nations of the world, brought to you by Yakko Water.
United States, Canada, Mexico, Panama, Haiti, Jamaica, Peru, a Republic, Dominican, Cuba, Caribbean, Cuba, El Salvador, too, Puerto Rico, Colombia, Venezuela, Honduras, Guyana, and still, Guatemala, Bolivia, then Argentina, and Ecuador, Chile, Brazil, Costa Rica, Belize, Nicaragua, Bermuda, Bahamas, Tobago, San Juan, Paraguay, Uruguay, Suriname, and Guyana, Barbados, and Guam. Norway and Sweden and Iceland and Finland and Germany now in peace. Switzerland, Austria, Czechoslovakia, Italy, Turkey and Greece. Poland, Romania, Scotland, Albania, Ireland, Russia, Oman, Bulgaria, Saudi Arabia, Hungary, Cyprus, Iraq and Iran, Syria, Lebanon, Israel, Jordan, Kuwait, Bahrain, the Netherlands, Luxembourg, Belgium and Portugal. Trinidad, Denmark, and Spain. India, Pakistan, Burma, Afghanistan, Thailand, Nepal, and Bhutan, Cambodia, Malaysia, and Bangladesh, Asia, and China, Korea, Japan, Mongolia, Laos, and Japan, Indonesia, the Philippines, and Taiwan, Sri Lanka, New Guinea, Sumatra, New Zealand, the Borneo, and Vietnam, Indonesia, Morocco, Uganda, Angola, Zimbabwe, Djibouti, Botswana, Mozambique, Zambia, Swaziland, Gambia, Guinea, Nigeria, Ghana. Running Lesotho and Malawi, Togo, the Spanish Sahara is gone. Niger, Nigeria, China, Liberia, Egypt, Medina, Gabon, Tanzania, Somalia, Kenya, and Mali, Sierra Leone, and Algeria, Dahomey, Namibia, Senegal, Libya, Cameroon, Congo, Zaire, Ethiopia, Guinea, Bissau, Madagascar, Rwanda, Mayor, Cayman, Hong Kong, Abu Dhabi, Qatar, Yugoslavia, Greece, Mauritania, Lithuania, Monaco, Italy, Bolivia, Palestine, Fiji, Australia, Sudan.
We have to do.
Oh, goodness gracious, is it dinner time? Because I am starving.
No, Pinky, not that. That Yakko's World song has got me a thinking. Watson, Yosemite Sam slipped out. What do you want? If we're going to take over the world, we need to take over every one of those countries. But which one do we take over first? United States, Canada, Mexico, Panama?
Rain, I'm feeling hungry.
Hungry? How about Turkey?
Ooh, Turkey sounds great.
Oh, so we should start with Turkey then.
I love Turkey.
Not Hungary.
No, not after we have Turkey.
When will we go for Hungary then?
Why would we want to be hungry?
Well, that's beside the point, Pinky, but the Hungarians like it.
Who?
The Hungarians. They like being hungry.
They do?
Yes.
Well, why would they like being hungry?
Because they're Hungarians.
Well, just because they're Hungarian doesn't mean they have to be hungry.
Of course it does. What else would they be?
They could be not hungry.
That would make them Bulgarians.
Wait, you mean to tell me they have turkey right in front of them and they'd rather be hungry?
Exactly.
Well, that's crazy.
Why? They've been hungry for 1,000 years.
1,000 years? God, they must be really skinny. Don't they ever eat?
What a silly question. Of course they eat.
Then why are they hungry?
Because...
They're Hungarians.
All right, forget about Hungary.
I will, after we have turkey. Or chili, too. I like chili.
Chile. In South America, between Argentina and Bolivia.
Seems like a bloody long way for chili, but yeah, okay.
You think Chile is a better choice than Turkey?
I think either one is better than being hungry.
Why?
Because who wants to be hungry?
The Hungarians.
All right, let's say I'm a Hungarian.
All right.
And I am hungry.
You mean your country is?
My country?
Yes, your country is hungry.
The entire country is hungry?
Yes.
So all of us are hungry?
Yes.
Okay, let's say we sit down in front of a huge meal and we eat until we are full.
Right.
And we wouldn't be hungry anymore.
Why not?
Because we just ate.
You're still going to be hungry.
Even after turkey and chili?
Hungarians are always going to be hungry, Pinky. They're proud of that.
They're proud of being hungry.
Absolutely. And why shouldn't they be?
But we can still have turkey.
That's the plan.
Oh, thank goodness.
But now, Pinky, we must think of how to prepare for all of this.
I don't care how they prepare it, as long as they don't put it in grease.
Grease? In southern Europe, across from Italy.
Can't find Greece any closer?
Well, no, that's what Greece is.
Fine, whatever. Just don't let them put our turkey in Greece.
Well, that's ridiculous. You can't put turkey in Greece.
Olive Garden does it.
Pinky, it would be impossible to pick up turkey and drop it into Greece. It wouldn't fit.
Oh, don't be silly, brain. People put that turkey in Greece all the time, though. It isn't very good for you.
This conversation isn't very good for me, Pinky. Hungary, Greece, Chile, Turkey, what next?
Can we serve it on China?
Ladies and gentlemen, voice bar to Rob Paulsen.
Thank you guys. It's really a pleasure. Thank you. I'm going to take poetic license as this is our last show for this tour, but we do a lot of conventions, right? We do a lot of
Comic-Cons.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, you have a little one in San Diego.
We occasionally pop in there.
Yeah, and you know, they're so ubiquitous. I mean, they're springing up like zits on a 12-year-old. We love doing them. And Mo and I are together a lot, and I always sing United States, Canada, Mexico, Panama.
He always sings.
And that's poor guys had to put up a lot. But about 4 years ago, I was at a convention, and we were doing Q&A, and for our purposes, I say that because we're by the water, for our purposes, let's presume it was Carl Weezer.
The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
Yeah. So we're doing a Q&A, and yeah, yes sir, hi, what's your name? My name is Carl Weezer. I said, oh, hi Carl, what's your question? Well, it's not really a question, it's more of a statement. That song with all the countries, the Eccles wrote, yeah, whatever. It doesn't really have any relevance anymore. Oh, and but what do you mean by that? Well, there are a lot of countries that are gone, new ones that sprung up, and it just really, you know, I don't mean to be a turd in the punch bowl. But you are. I tell you what, Carl. Yeah? Come on up here. Well, I don't. I'm kind of. No. Come on, I'm not going to. I don't want. Ow! My scapula!
So after I bailed Rob out of jail.
Yeah. So I went back to Randy, and I was a little bit sideways, you know, because I'm a jerk. And I told Randy what happened. Randy, being the magnanimous genius he is, said.
I just said, well, he's right. I mean, since we wrote that song, the Soviet Union's broken up into 15 new countries. Yugoslavia's broken up into a slew of countries, and a lot of other countries have new names. So the song needs to be updated. Whoa. So written a verse to bring to you all the new countries that have come into being since we wrote the song back in the 1990s.
Yeah. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Carl. The song has now been updated, and this is the new version of Yakko's World.